The new Isimba Bridge under construction is of immense social and economic value to the eastern region and the country at large, says the Minister of Energy and Mineral Development. Connecting Kayunga District to Kamuli District across the River Nile, the bridge has been on the spotlight in the recent past due to allegations of corruption which threatened to stall the project.
The significance of this bridge is to connect, first of all, the two districts, but also to promote trade between the Buganda and the Busoga region. And secondly, in case we have any problem on the upper bridges, for us from the east, even myself, I will be using this bridge.
According to Uganda National Roads Authority, the project, one of the second components of the power dam, is on schedule.
Works are fully in progress. The contractor has fully mobilized. Because the bridge involves two components, basically two parts of the bridge. We have a 450 meter span this side, another 430 the other side. So as you can see, about 8 piers already up, even more piles underground. We've done 28 of 38. So the progress is good. We are hopeful to complete on schedule. The works are scheduled to be completed by end of December 2020.
In an interaction with the UAGCL management, several issues that need urgent attention from government were raised. This includes construction of staff housing to enhance operations of the dam, funds to support the Community Development Action Plan, which currently has a shortfall of 16 billion shillings, enhancement of the last mile connection to spur demand for electricity, harmonization of opinion between the regulator and UAGCL so as to follow the dictates of the power purchase agreement.
We've really enjoyed visiting the plant with her, and we've taken all the comments. She's given us a few tips on how to improve in our communication and other areas, and we'll take that seriously. But we are grateful to having had her visit. Thank you very much.
The total energy dispatched from Isimba from January to December 2019 was 717 gigawatts per hour, with an average plant availability of 98%. Dennis Igoa and Robin Yoso for UBC News at Isimba.